Hi, in this video I want to have a look at how to get the best Dragon Spirit equipment. And a while back there was a new set of three orange equipment sets were released in the game: Fierce, Justice and Magus for the Wild Knight and Mage categories. These are quite a big improvement again over the old sets. It's again, the pattern seems very similar. It's again roughly that the unenhanced new sets are equivalent to an enhanced 10 of the previous set, which is of course, very nice amount because it takes you a lot of materials to enhance to level 10. And besides that, enhancing those new sets to level 1 is of course also going to be a lot cheaper than enhancing the previous set from 10 to 11. So having those new sets is definitely going to be nice, but there are, as previously as well, there are some catches. One is that the scrolls only start to drop at floor 55 of the labyrinth. And that is, that's quite high. That's quite tough to get into. The other is that, maybe even a more tough requirement is that you need to enhance your Dragon Spirit XP to level 45. I'm currently 39. The requirements get quite, they keep increasing. I don't know yet how it is for going further than where I am. I'm 38 going to 39, so that is like 2,700,000, I believe. So it's going to take you quite some time to get there if you are a non-spender. So it's good to focus on carrying, being able to carry a lot of stuff. Normally during my labyrinth runs, I'm focusing on getting a lot of those Dragon Spirit XP items, especially the 2,500, because they are lighter relatively. And what I don't, what I cannot get in 2,500, I carry in materials to improve my my gear, and some small things. If I find good scrolls or other goodies, I pick that up as well. So currently my capacity is at 1,215, and I can do a run every one day and 8 hours approximately, and I intend to do that. To keep going. Still, it takes me quite long to upgrade levels, so I'm not sure how long I can stay motivated. But for now, I still have the energy. I'm now just going to play through a few of those floors. My strategy, I'm not really focused on being very strong. I'm more focused on carrying a lot. So I'm not winning all of the player versus player encounters. Previously, almost everyone also used the mage tactic. I have not switched to knight yet. Quite some people have, and since they have changed and made the recovery more beneficial, definitely the knight is relatively better than before. So I'm now running out of mana. That's because I'm using a heroic helmet, but I get a lot more health for that. So in my eyes, it's a good trade-off. I'm taking those intensity crystals one, but actually I'm not too crazy about them. I have all my Dragon skills already enhanced to level 1, I think even to level 2, so it's not so beneficial. I can better focus on other stuff, I feel. So at floor 41, you start having those Dragon Spirit XP 2500 items that they drop from random chests as well. Before that, you could only get them in the boss battle. So most of the time, starting from around 40, 41, I start to explore all the rooms in a floor. I tend to want to do the boss first. It's just kind of a small tactic that if I do the boss first, often I need more mage attacks to finish off the boss, and after that I sometimes can still recuperate a bit by with three strikes, three mage attacks, killing some regular monsters. So that's why I tend to try to go for the boss first. And if you've seen my videos, you know of the tactic. You always have to do six steps to get to the boss. So meaning that actually, if I'm not too distracted by making this video, I know that over here could never be the boss, because that would kind of separate this room, making that inaccessible. So I know, okay, I don't go there to find the boss. And I knew, yeah, then it should be on this side. Here I need four, and it's just now it doesn't matter that much. 91, so let's for the sake of this video, I don't want to spend too much time. I'm just going to assume I can fill up everything with Dragon Spirit XP. So I don't do that. Normally I do it one by one, but and that is going to take a bit more time, so let's just do it like this for now. Okay, I didn't encounter any more monsters, unfortunately. I don't take those source stones of the higher levels yet. I don't feel I am going to use them anytime soon. I will have a hard time enough to get enough materials to enhance everything to level 5 even. I do have some I do have some oh wait, it could actually be above here. I'm not paying attention. I do have some source stones of level 2, because at the lower level with the purple gear I was actually enhancing my stuff to 6 or 7. So I think I should have plenty of those to upgrade it to any level that I will get to. Okay, let's I tend to take out the small ones first. Don't know whether that is a good tactic. Maybe that also depends on the level. Don't know if anyone has any feedback on that. It's always appreciated. So I just made a separate guide, by the way, on the satchel capacity, how to max that, a separate video. So have a look at that if you're interested. My tactic behind it is that I want to carry as much as possible, as fast as possible. I also made a video on combining the. So, just to sorry before I finish that remark, if you have gone to four rooms without encountering any monster, you know you're not going to get to the boss on that route, because you always encounter a minimum of two monsters before you get to a boss. So if you have done four rooms, and then there's only one room left between you and the boss, so you know, okay, that route is not going to take me to the boss. As I said, I want to go to the boss first, so I then switch to another route. That was a bit stupid. I could have known that. That's what you get when you try to make a video and try to play smart. Always have to keep counting how many steps did you already go. So always have your VIP on, eh? That gives quite some benefits, like switching these rooms. Okay, yeah. Switching the rooms in the floor. And it allows you to carry more, to be stronger, have more health potions, etc, etc. So just make sure you have VIP on. Oh, I shouldn't have done that. It's another mistake. I should have used the mage attack for that. At a certain time on this level, I sometimes don't do use mage attack to just recuperate a bit. For now, I still carry all the orange gear that I can get. But before doing that, you should make sure you have enough to recuperate. Like at this time, I have 10 to recuperate, 37, 47. So that now I could, in theory, do it. And I got more to recuperate after this battle. And now I have 15 to recuperate, so hopefully I hit some simple monster. Just a chest with resources. I never grabbed those resources. Well, I have other ways to get to my resources, and yeah, it's really beneficial. I could have also done two hits here, by the way, two mage hits, so to recover a bit more, but okay. So I'm already running out of it, so now it's time to get into the I favor XP. I'm just going to take quite some chunk again. I favor XP over materials, because I first want to get to a high level, actually. That yeah, getting my Dragon Spirit XP to the high level is going to be the hard part of getting to the next gear. So whenever I get a chance. So here I have again done 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. So I already know exactly where the boss will be, actually. Sorry, lost my train of thought. Oh yeah, I was going to talking about going on and on about the Dragon Spirit XP. That is going to be tough. I mean, it can take months before I can complete it. So grab it any chance that I can get. Okay, I'm using up a little bit too much mana here. If I get a chance, I will try to recuperate a bit. Maybe just do two attacks here and finish off the rest with a conventional attacks, so that allows to recuperate a bit. And maybe I should do that one more time if I get a chance. Two attacks, three attacks. Going to remove a bit more. There's quite some randomness in what drops, so there have been times that I've not been able to get even like 80 or even 70 of those Dragon Spirit XP items, even if I started at 31. I used to start at 21. I started and now start at 31. So I tend to first grab all the materials as well, Because yeah, you want to have useful stuff. This is going to be another player versus player battle. So this is at level 50, you sometimes get like some few intensity crystals level 2. So it can be quite nice if you're able to win these. I'm not always winning them. Actually not tried the to complete the you need to win within a certain amount of strikes. I don't actually recall which how many strikes, but this ha has happened to me that I had a draw that was happening in the arena. Still using some conventional attacks just to conserve some mana. So one mage attack and one conventional attack for those side monsters. Don't want to waste mana here. I'm using up enough as it is. Five attacks for this boss. That's a nice amount, 130. Well, let's just. Throw away again a batch of those materials. Normally, when I have the time and not making a video, I will measure everything out, just make sure I don't waste anything. But yeah, and now just don't want to waste too much. The video is going to be long enough as it is. So hopefully this gives you just a bit of an idea like how can you get through this this labyrinth? This is one of the stronger players, dragon spirit wise, in my kingdom. And it's yeah, I'm also not fully focused on the strengths, as I mentioned. I'm more focused on the satchel capacity, so I don't always win. But this one I was still able to win, which is very weird because this guy has strength as level 48. So he must be experimenting a bit with his dragon spirit, I assume. So that's nice. Two intensity crystals, level 2. Those are still worth picking up, I think. Although, as like I said, I've already done everything to level 2. But yeah, you can always use them and convert them to intensity crystals, level 3. So ideally, I would have liked to get some more scrolls that are beneficial for me. That more there are some equipment pieces I don't have that many scrolls of yet for the mage set. But yeah, you have to be lucky. I'm now getting to a stage that I don't feel so confident anymore, that I'm that still a lot is going to drop. So we'll just take it piece by piece. I'm still going to conserve some mana. Yeah. Should have done that more on lower levels, but I'm not yeah, paying enough attention, it seems. So here you get it. This is how I do it. So yeah, you see that you get quite a large amount of Dragon Spirit XP during the complete run. Six, that is. Let's just throw it all away now. And that is the maximum I can hold. I'm still willing to throw those. Intensity crystals away, the level 1 intensity crystal level 1, in case I find something worth picking up. Normally, I measure out my mana usage a bit better, and I tend to, yeah, have a closer match running out of mana and health at the same time. I'm also not really paying attention. I should have put my health items already, but yeah, that is like I said, I'm making a video now, and that is just a bit more. Yeah, more difficult to pay full attention to everything. Okay. So sometimes, one time actually only so far, but yeah, it's not like I've already been playing at this level a long time, so I do get to 53. Most of the times I was stuck at 52. That's okay. Oh yeah, one thing, I'm not really focused on the leaderboard. I tend to be with the top 10. Every place in the leaderboard that you are higher up gives a bit better rewards. Every week, at the end of every week, you get leaderboard awards for the one who gets to the highest floor, and if there are multiple people to the same floor, it's about who gets to that floor first. Now I have to see how I do with my conventional attack, still quite well, so I'm going to get to 53, which is nice. I'm not so happy that I don't get a lot of nice stuff, to be honest, but okay. I'm getting a lot of Dragon Spirit XP, and that's what it is really about at the moment. Although slight improvements would also be nice. So those leaderboard prices are nice. The higher you get, the better. But there are some players that are still a lot stronger that will get higher than me anyway. That get already to level 60, 59, 60, 61. I'm not getting there. So that's not very. I'm not going to get to the top spots. So the next and for the rest, it's kind of a choice. I mean, it maybe it's worthwhile. I haven't really paid too much focus on that, but maybe it's worthwhile to get. I had already done that. Okay, I can just walk in this one. I'm not going to be able to beat any monsters here, but who knows? I encounter an empty chest. Still want to do some damage. I mean an unguarded chest. This can always happen. But no. So it might be worthwhile, for example, to just in your last run before the timer resets to already go to almost the highest level that you can, and then quickly go to the highest level so that you get to a certain floor first. I tend to not do that, just play in my own way. It's beneficial to get higher. I now get 3 hour cooldown timer, which is nice, and I get quite some dragon XP and dragon spirit XP, although quite some the dragon spirit XP is very small compared to what I even gather in one during one run. Maybe at the higher levels it's better. I haven't really looked at that, how much better it is. It is better, but how much better it is. So it's not really my focus to do that. I'm not also my dragon spirit is not built to be as strong as possible. I'm more carrying as much as possible, so that makes it focusing on getting to the highest floor, scoring leaderboard prizes, not really in line with my strategy. But if you can do it and can score high, it's worthwhile. Just keep into consideration that you don't pay more, so to say, pay more than that you benefit, because if you go for those leaderboard prices, and if you do that by, for example, starting at level floor 51 and just getting to the highest level as fast as possible, but in the end it means you carry less than half of your capacity worth of Dragon Spirit XP, maybe the what you get is actually a lot less valuable than what you pay, so to say. Okay, that's my tip on that. It was a bit of a lengthy video. I hope it has been worthwhile. I'm not getting to floor 55 yet. I will just build towards that. I'm not very in a rush to get there. I'm still very far away from Dragon Spirit level experience level 45. So it doesn't matter yet. As I grow my grow more levels, my Dragon Spirit will be stronger, and I will eventually get there. And I'm quite confident I will get to floor 55, 56, 57 before I reach my Dragon Spirit to 45. So I have my scrolls probably ready by the time that I get there, which is actually the same as happened with the previous set. I also had my scrolls already ready before my Dragon Spirit Spirit experience level caught up. Okay, hey, again, thanks for watching. If you have any questions or tips, please feel free to share.